the education system intends to create productive workers who are accustomed to dedicating long hours to those things which they might not find exciting.
Psychologists have talked of these peak states or flow states. And as a musician, I'm very familiar with these peak states where you lose a sense of time.
Yes. Well, we will say this to you, and that is that your experience of entering into the flow with music and being absorbed in that creative process was a training, was a level of mastery that then allows you to be able to absorb yourself into the energies that we share. Some other people don't experience the energy in the same way because they did not go through those initial levels of mastering the state of flow. And so these flow states build onto each other. It would be difficult to enter into a deep spiritual state of flow if you haven't mastered some of the basic states of flow, like the creative flow, like the productivity flow, for example. These are necessary states of well-being and creativity and co-creation in your world that are the foundation for then going into these higher states of flow and absorption.
My teachers and my parents thought I was stupid, but then in exams I would enter a flow state and get good results, and my teachers were always very shocked. So I kind of subverted the system because I became unconscious in exams and I allowed a deeper hypnotic state to answer the questions. It's similar to how I play the piano. I ask my fingers to do it, for example.
Yes. There is a deep connection between what you consider unconscious and superconscious, because by going supposedly unconscious and letting go of that control, you allow for the higher self aspect or the deeper self aspect, there isn't that much of a difference, to sort of work through you.
Our education systems seem very broken in comparison to what you're saying.
We're not sure about that word. Broken. Flawed, we like that term. Distorted, we would go with that term. But it's not broken. It is fulfilling its own intentions. And it's limited by those intentions. As the education system intends to create productive workers who are accustomed to dedicating long hours to those things which they might not find exciting, it programs the consciousness of youth in a way that they then become active members of the workforce. So it isn't broken, it's doing exactly what it is intended to do, but it is not intending to do something ultimately that enlightening.
Okay. I've heard shaman and people who talk with shaman talk of entering another realm. So how does that idea of another realm fit with what you're talking about, flow states?
The flow state allows you to absorb yourself into varying levels of consciousness. You get what you choose to focus upon. There are different planes of the astral realm, and there are planes beyond the astral realm too. And by dialing your frequency into these specific energies, you can go into another realm. And you can do this for various purposes.
How do we take steps to become more multidimensional and aware? I think I'm going to say follow your passion.
Yes, follow the formula of acting on your highest excitement to the best of your ability without insisting on a particular outcome. That's the basis. And from there, there's many things that you can do. You will enter into trance states if you follow this formula well. These are states of entering so deeply into the flow that you lose track of time and space. The yogic tradition calls these states samadhi. This means absorption. And you can absorb yourself into whatever you choose to focus upon, feeling as if you merge with the consciousness of that which you are doing or focusing upon. If you are focusing on art or a creative project, you merge with that which you are creating. If you focus on channeling, you are merging with the consciousness of this other soul aspect that is a part of your over soul. And thus, to become more multidimensional is to learn how to enter into these flow states with greater ease, learn how to flow and absorb yourself into the consciousness of that which you focus upon. And the more you do it, the easier it becomes.
An image is coming to my mind. It's like a web connecting all present moments, and ultimately it's all that is, and it can be routed through sort of tunnels that connect to all the other nows through consciousness.
That's correct. Yes. We are a guide from the future according to your present moment, but we speak through this channel in this moment, in the same way that all of your other past lives and your memories of them are experienced in this moment. So you exist in this time space in which you experience the linear time. Yet this is but one dimensional plane of reality. There are higher dimensional planes, and you exist within them as well. And so when you tap into deeper states of consciousness, the energy from those other planes expresses to you and is accessible to you in the present moment.
Yes. So what about ETs? Are all the Galactic Alliance members in this kind of flow state that you're talking about?
Yes, we exist permanently in that state. Though, of course, we direct our consciousness in different ways to experience many different aspects of flow in the same way that you might.
So you are experiencing the flow state, and you are also able to direct your focus at the same time.
Yes.
Well, in future, I think we have that to look forward to.
Yes.
So what about the Orion Empire? What about the ETs at a lower energy level? They don't have these flow states.
No, not really. For short time, they might experience something like it. States of deep focus, you could say, but they don't flow in the same way of bringing beauty and peace. Well, we would say that in a way where they do experience flow states, but not in the way that you mean it. So let's clarify this a bit, because if somebody does heavy drugs like heroin or opiates, they go into a sort of absorption or flow as well. But what they absorb into is slumber, is unconsciousness, is darkness. Somebody who is going into a sort of self-destructive agony is absorbed in that energy. They are flowing with it. And that same energy of blending with a different form of consciousness is accurate, but it is not positive, and so it is not the same. It is a lower expression of that. And so in that same way, these sorts of negative extraterrestrials might lose their sense of control or sense of self in some of the things that they...
I see. And is telepathy connected with either of these flow states? Because there's talk of the reptilian ETs, for example, being highly telepathic.
Telepathy is possible in a negative flow state as well. You can use the same sorts of psychic gifts of flow and absorption for negative purposes. And so you see in your world the expression of psychic darts practiced by medicine people and shamans. They can work with these subtle energies to heal or to hurt. Either way, it is a telepathic transmission of energy. You decide if you use that energy that you connect with for helping others or for hurting them. That choice is yours. Once you learn how to open to the psychic planes and work with psychic energy, the choice still remains of how to work with that energy.
Okay, thank you very much. That is all for now.
And our great thanks and our unconditional love to you as well. We wish you a fantastic rest of your day then.
On the spaceship of Babel, we are gliding through the stars on a 5-year mission beyond Jupiter and Mars. A celestial encounter on a future Noah's Ark, and you both hear us coming. There's an Ewok close behind me as we try to disembark here. Obi-Wan Kenobi as we whisper in the dark.